I didn't think that this stream was gonna happen for a little while. Quite frankly, my power went out multiple times already today, and at some points when it came on, it wasn't staying on for very long, so it would be. I'm noticing that. There we go. I mean, I could have just done reset to default. Yeah, the power wasn't staying on today for me, even when it was coming on. So I was like kind of thinking that it was just gonna not be reliable for any particular period of time. But then just before 3 o'clock, my time here, it came back on and it hasn't come shut off. It hasn't shut off again since. So I'm figuring I'm probably good. Like it stopped. The downpour has stopped for now at least. So we'll see if it comes back and it starts really, shitstorming outside again. But for now, I think we're pretty good to play a brand new game. Just grabbing a little water myself. Remember to stay rehydrated. A little while back on my Discord, I put up a poll and I asked people what they wanted to see me play. Particularly, I haven't played a 3D game in a little while. Like, the last 3D adventure game that I remember playing is Tomb Raider over almost a year ago at this point. So I put it up to people. I was like, what 3D game do you want me to play? I put up a few options, and it was between SpongeBob SquarePants, Battle for Bikini Bottom, or Hellblade: Senua's Sacrifice, and ultimately SpongeBob 1. There was a few other options, but they didn't get as many votes as those two. So it was tied for a little while, and then I had a tiebreaker vote with SpongeBob. So that's what we're doing today. All right, I guess without anything else left to say, let's go ahead and get started. Brand new game. Bubbles.
Welcome to Bikini Bottom, a normally peaceful undersea sanctuary. Today it will be transformed into a
I
theater
gotta
of
put on
human horror,
subtitles.
wherein our little yellow friend will play the starring role.
Today's the big day. I have devised an ingenious plan to finally steal the Krabby Patty formula. And if Bikini Bottom happens to get demolished in the process, oh well. With my brand new Duplicatotron 3000, I'll clone an army of robots that will wreak mayhem and destruction at my command!
I'm noticing.
One last review of the checklist. Let's see.
Noticing
Our
that
new
that obey
robot
switch isn't.
is Plankton a genius. Answer yes. Okay, checklist complete. Throw in the switch! Welcome, my perfectly obedient robot army. Hang on. I want to get a photo for my scrapbook. Hey, hello? What do you think you're doing?
Why does he even have an obey
Oh,
disobey switch?
wait. But I'm your master. I made you. No.
Someone should put him in a box floating down the river.
Another perfect day playing robots and racehorses.
Yeah, only I keep getting the racehorses and the robots mixed up.
Wouldn't it be great if we had real robots to play with, Patrick?
Oh!
Robo Junior, or Zorlon, or maybe Frankie.
Yeah, these unreal robots are getting boring. Hey, what if we put the robots in here?
Oh, how shellfish of you.
It's not just any shell. It's my magic wishing shell.
Wow, that's great, Patrick.
So we put the toy robots in here.
Okay.
Then we say the magic wishing words and shake the magic wishing shell.
Okay.
Then we go to sleep And in the morning, we'll have real robots to play with!
But Patrick, aren't we going to say the magic wishing words?
You already did!
So, okay is the magic wishing word?
It used to be Alakazama Alabala Wisna Tikitana Fushbar Griddle Bits von Vita Schnauzer, but I kept forgetting it.
Are you sure this'll work?
Sure. Last week I only had one big cookie crumb and I was really hungry, so I put my cookie crumb in the magic wishing shell, then I said the magic wishing word and shook it, and in the morning I had lots of little cookie crumbs!
Patrick, I proclaim that tomorrow is going to be the best day ever.
Good night, SpongeBob.
Good night, Patrick.
The next morning.
I forgot that was his alarm.
With robots, gonna play with robots, gonna play with robots, gonna play with. Whoa! Gary, did you do that?
Bikini. That's actually kind of funny. Your bikini bottom stinks. All right.
Yeah, Gary. It sure looks like we're in a doozy of a pickle. I think I'm gonna have to learn a lot in order to fix this mess.
Meow.
What a fantastic idea! These signs will provide important tips to help me out. How do I read the signs?
Meow.
Oh, okay. Press this button to read the signs.
Right.
So if I want to come back and talk to you again, just walk up to you and press this button. I'd better get started now, Gary. I think that this is going to be a very long day.
Explore the kitchen. Okay. Explore the bedroom. Oh my. Explore the attic. Explore the closet. Okay. So here's the thing. Like, need more golden spatulas. Here's the thing. I know, like, at its core, SpongeBob is supposed to be, like, a kid's show in a lot of ways. And he's supposed to be pretty stupid, but, like, he's still supposed to be an adult most of the time, right? And it just seems weird for him to be, like, him or Patrick to be, like, adults and be like, oh, magic is real, we're gonna make a wish to make, this robot's real.
Myself a snack, but there's no time. It shines.
Okay, apparently these are. Okay, I need to get. I feel like Sorry. Gameplay settings, invert controls. Vertical. Let's do both. All right. No vibration. And audio settings, no. Language settings, subtitles. Here we go. All right. And we're gonna save our game. Okay. Okay. Oh. There are shiny objects. Shiny objects are very valuable and may be traded to help SpongeBob along his quest. SpongeBob will need to collect many shiny objects in order to complete his quest and defeat the robot menace. There are 5 different colors of shiny objects. Red, yellow, green, blue, and purple. Red is the most common and least valuable. Purple is the most rare and therefore most valuable. More valuable shiny objects are usually harder to find or are in dangerous places. Got it. Alright. SpongeBob may see how well he's doing by pressing the right trigger. The number in the upper right shows how many shiny objects he has. Number in the upper center is golden spatulas. Lower right is how many of Patrick's lost socks he's found. And the upper is how many power. Okay. No, I reverse the controls. This always happens with me. I'm never, like, really confident in how I've made the. Okay. I only needed 10. I mean, yeah. Oh, hey, look, underwear. Nope. I can only carry 3. This is a pair of SpongeBob's underwear. SpongeBob will lose a pair of underwear every time he gets hit by a robot or touches dangerous objects or surfaces. Like this. When SpongeBob. Thank you for the lurk. This is me gaming. Okay, Blake, hope you're having a good day. Thank you for being here. When SpongeBob helps us all his underwear, he must start that area back over again. SpongeBob may get back underwear he has lost by collecting additional pairs along the way. SpongeBob starts out wearing 3 pairs of underwear, but there are special pairs of golden underwear hidden in Bikini Bottom, which if found will allow SpongeBob to wear more than 3 pairs at a time. SpongeBob can check how many pairs with the right trigger.
I feel like a new sponge.
Is there anything? Okay, nope. SpongeBob may jump by pressing A. Pressing A while he's mid-jump will cause him to double jump for extra height, but SpongeBob can only double jump once per jump. At 69 for a very brief moment. What? Oh, wait, this is where I already was.
Maybe a little bounce on the old bed.
Here we go. Into the attic. Press X and SpongeBob will do a bubble spin. SpongeBob may use the bubble spin to smash open tikis or push buttons on walls or defeat most robots. SpongeBob may also bubble spin in mid-jump to hit things that are higher up.
Sometimes pushing a simple button is the most satisfying. Push, 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 push.
There we go. That took me a while.
This is where I keep all my old comic books.
All right. To see how well SpongeBob is doing every level of the game, press when pause, move to select the level. When a level is selected, press A to view the details. When the details is open, press on the right, each golden spatula knows about. By pressing A for a golden spatula, Botchell can take a taxi directly to the area of that spatula anywhere. Oh, neat. Press Y when on the ground and SpongeBob will do a bubble bash attack. The bubble bash can smash tikis or robots or push buttons that are directly above SpongeBob. When you see this icon, SpongeBob can stand on it and do the bubble bash attack to break tikis above him. Okay, so... wasn't expecting that. Oh, hey, platforms. Shoot. No.
Boy, Patrick will be glad to have this back.
Wait, was that it? I think that was it. Press B in midair and we'll do a bubble bounce. Bubble bounce attack can smash tiki's robots that are directly above SpongeBob or push buttons on the ground. SpongeBob may only do the bubble bounce attack in move in midair. Neat. Whoa. I don't know why I would bubble bounce. Okay, so... yeah, so that's an attack, this is air attack, and this is... got it! Alright! I think I learned... can I break this? No, that's really nothing. Okay. I think I learned most of everything. 50 shiny objects, yes. This is a golden spatula! No, those are SpongeBob shirts. Golden spatulas are needed to unlock new areas of Bikini Bottoms. SpongeBob will need to collect many golden spatulas in order to find and defeat the source of the rampaging robots. That's... okay. We're exiting the house now, Gary!
There's nothing like the sounds of your own neighborhood.
Go away, SpongeBob. You're polluting my thinking space.
Steal the Krabby Patty formula again, eh, Plankton? Well, you won't get away with it.
I've got bigger fish to fry. I've got to figure out how to regain control of the chum bucket from those robots.
Where did they come from?
Where? I don't know. Not for me, though, that's for sure. They just showed up out of nowhere and started calling me rude names and throwing things. They even bent all my spoons. I love those spoons like they were my children.
That's terrible.
Oh, won't you help me stop them? Before they bend all my forks?
Not the forks! Of course I'll help. But wait, I'm supposed to collect a whole lot of golden spatulas.
Golden spatulas, eh? SpongeBob, if you could get me back into the chum bucket, I'll give you a bucket full of golden spatulas. In your dreams.
You've got a deal.
All right. So. That one requires 5.
It's Mr. Krabs!
SpongeBob, this flapping robot Krasis.
Wow!
Krusty Krab lose money like a sinking ship. No money means no more Krusty Krab. No more Krusty Krab means no more fry cooking for you.
That sounds less than like Mr. Krabs than my impression of Mr. Krabs. That sounds nothing like Mr. Krabs.
No more fry cooking?
But because you're gullible, I'm going to help you out. And of course make a small profit in return. I've got a few golden spatulas that I'll be willing to trade to you for some of those shiny objects.
Oh, neat. Wait. How am I supposed to get on there? What? I don't understand the point of that. Okay. Haha. That thing works like a...
Hey, SpongeBob! I just dropped by to give you a bubble hand!
Bubble buddy!
You see, you're going to need to learn some new bubble-blowing moves if you're going to journey to the ninth dimension and defeat the giant monkey man!
But, all I need to do is figure out how to get rid of these robots.
Oh, yeah, sorry. I've been in the soap bottle a little too long. Where were we?
Something about new bubble moves.
Right! Press this button, and you'll launch yourself straight up in the air with bubble power that defeats anything that is directly above you.
Yeah, I already knew that.
Opening presents.
All right. That's 15 spatulas. Oh, hey, Patrick.
Hey, Patrick. Nice sock.
What sock?
The one you're standing on.
Oh, that one. It's lost.
Well, if that one's lost, where are your other socks?
Oh, they're more lost. A bunch of robots came through here and stole my whole sock collection. I could use some help getting them back.
Sure thing, Patrick. What are best friends for?
Okay, then. For every 10 socks you bring back to me, I'll give you a golden turkey baster.
You mean spatula?
Bless you.
I don't know why. I don't know why. That made me laugh. Goo Lagoon, locked off. There's a missile in the backyard. Yeah, I know. Oh, so am I supposed to activate that one and then the one for between SpongeBob's house and Squidward's house?
Now I can wear 4 pairs of underwear. This is great.
Yep.
Like a spring breeze.
Probably. Okay, whoop. Ugh. There we go. Come on. Yay, 2 golden spatulas! Alright. Claws in on top of the pineapple. I found 2 out of 8 socks. It doesn't tell me how many shiny objects there are. And so that I find a little annoying. Okay. Oh. This isn't actually part of the level. Okay. Let's see what's inside Squidward's house.
First, those stupid robots ruined a perfectly relaxing mud bath this morning, and now you show up. Can my day get any more dreary?
I am so sorry, Squidward. Patrick and I were just playing a game.
Oh, I correct myself. I should have known that whole robot problem involved both of you.
Squidward, I don't know what to do. How can I fix everything?
Why don't you move to another town? That should help out more than enough. Move to another town. I cracked me up. But seriously, just jump around like an idiot. That should at least make me smile.
I didn't know Squidward had a lamp.
I like how all these shells and stuff like that are just, kind of drawings. Exit the house. Okay. Wait, is this all I can do? What?
Okay, just stop jumping, will you? If you take this golden spatula, will you please go away?
See, Squidward? I knew that you could help me out. You're the best.
Don't touch me.
I didn't expect that. Man, I'm...
Hey, Squidward.
Didn't I pay you to go away?
Alright, so there's only the one room in Squidward's house. Okay, bizarre. I mean, we know it's at least 2 floors. Okay, so, yeah, the shiny objects... are unlimited. Got it.
Your treasure chest's looking a bit light, boy. Do you think I've got bilge water on the brain?
Wow! 3,000. Okay, good thing they're unlimited and I can, like, grind them out.
I love opening presents.
Alright, can I go? Yeah, I can enter Patrick's home.
Living under a rock. Now that's the life.
Nothing else here? I guess I should have expected nothing to be in Patrick's home. Alright. Well, I don't really have anything else to do, so... first area seems to be Jellyfish Fields. Whoops.
Don't forget to defeat...
Yeah, okay. Alright, let's take the taxi. Yeah!
The rolling green hills of Jellyfish Fields. A place to experience nature at its most raw. And sometimes a bit tender from the stings.
Run tender, I like it. Why did you leave your house, Squidward? Squidward, that objectively seems like a bad idea. Why did you leave your house? Squidward, why do you do these things?
Squidward, are you okay?
No, I'm not okay, you barnacle head. Do
Well, your nose does look pretty big. I mean, bigger than usual because it's usually pretty big. And you look clammy. And oh my gosh, you're bald!
I've always been bald, but now I'm stung all over.
Well, according to the Jellyfisher Field Manual, severe jellyfish stings can be treated effectively by applying a thick layer of King Jellyfish Jelly to the affected areas. King Jelly!
Well, I guess you're off to scale Sport Mountain and die a horrible death under the vicious tentacles of King Jellyfish. I'll stay here. Balled up here in excruciating pain.
You do that! Don't worry, Squidward! I'll bring back that King Jellyfish jelly for you to rub all over yourself.
Other voice, confidence voice, SpongeBob. Alright, so we get to enjoy this music. The classic SpongeBob Hawaiian style music. I can't remember the last time I actually watched an episode of SpongeBob SquarePants, though. Oh, okay, yeah. This is goo. SpongeBob and Patrick can't swim, so don't let them fall in the goo. Oh. That is true. They cannot swim. We learned that on an episode. This is a teleport box. When you have both teleport box in the area open, you may teleport between them by jumping inside. Okay, so I've activated this one, but can't teleport. I can't stand inside the box. Weird. Okay, don't know how to get that sock. Maybe I'll get an ability for it later on. Alright, let's see.
Fresh like a spring breeze.
Alright.
Oh, sparkly.
2K. Alright, so I can go this way, or feed a clam. Which... Alright. You do like that, SpongeBob, don't you? This game's actually really good so far. Let's feed this clam. Oh, it rebuilds the bridge. Why is there an airplane underwater? Now I think about it, airplanes have been seen underwater before.
I feel like a new sponge.
In SpongeBob, so I guess I shouldn't be that surprised. Alright. I like how I rebuilt the thing and now I'm going in a direction that is completely not that. I rebuilt the bridge, and then I was like, I'm not going to use the bridge, though. Super monster combo! Alright. I don't think I can actually get that. Because if I touch the goo... Alright. So, bridge or... these guys' heads. Well, it looks like the bridge is the way to go. Let's collect that golden thing. Whoop. Yeah, this just looks like... this doesn't look like advancement, so... and did I take damage? Nope. Okay. Let's go over the bridge. This is a checkpoint. If you are defeated after activating a checkpoint, you will restart at the checkpoint instead of the beginning of the area. Nice.
Just my side.
Okay. Super combo! Okay, what's up here? This is freeze fruit. Only Patrick can use the freeze fruit. Well, that doesn't help me. I just got an alert that Cuphead is available to watch on Netflix. You guys probably heard me get the alert. And I already watched the first episode. So, thanks for telling me something I already knew? I don't know if anyone else watching this has checked out Cuphead as of yet. The movie, not the movie, the TV show, not the game. I already played the game on stream. Alright. But yeah, I was only able to watch the first episode. Here's the cool thing. And by cool, I mean weird. I guess. Okay, nothing's here. While I was watching the first episode, there's a moment in the show. Whoops. There's a moment in the first episode where Cuphead is playing skee ball and he throws a ball into the wrong hole and the game responds, "Loser." And right at the point where it said loser, as soon as that was done, my power went out. So Cuphead turned off my power by losing his game. I guess it was revenge on me for all the times that I wasn't.
Hey Gary, what's taking?
I didn't even see Gary.
Wow, a bungee jump for a golden spatula. I must be in heaven.
All right. Alright, I don't think there's anything up here. No. At least not yet. King Jellyfish that way. Bungee jump this way. Whoa, whoa, whoa. This is a bungee jump. SpongeBob can bungee from it. Oh. To bungee a hook, just jump and touch it. Dive downwards, press A. To exit, press B. Alright, I think that's everything. Yeah! Golden spatula! Alright. So King Jellyfish is this way.
Sometimes pushing a simple button is the most satisfying. Push, 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 push.
Okay. Oh. Checkpoint. Oh, that's rude. It's hitting him with a giant ham. I guess that's a hammer? Are you just gonna stand there? Okay. Doesn't seem like a practical idea. I have almost 1,000 shiny objects. All right. Oh boy. Oh boy. All right, let's go this way first. There's nothing here, is there? Except for a white bat and a few shiny objects. Okay. All right. SpongeBob needs to know the bubble bowling move in order to play this game. He does not. All right, smashing more boxes. Smashing some jellyfish. Whoa. All right. So, okay. Doing all right here so far, I think. I have over 1,000 shiny objects. That happened at some point I didn't notice. This is goo. Yeah, okay. Is this just for... Yep. There we are. Ha ha! I do like the hammer joke. Alright. Jump. I feel like the first levels aren't going to be too entertaining to watch. Mostly because, I don't know, it's... Whoa. I feel like they're going to be pretty simple and hard to die to. And I just fucked up. But like as the game goes on, I'll probably get like harder levels and get more frustrated and stuff like that. So I know that this game, like the reason why it's so popular and the reason why it, got re-released and stuff like that is because it's surprisingly a very popular speedrun. Which is, interesting how the speedrun community will just grab onto, like, the most random game sometimes.
It shines. Boy, Patrick will be glad to have this back.
Alright. Oh, cool. That was really handy. I'm happy it did that. Whoa! Oh, this is a... balance thing. Teleport box. Yep, okay. Haha! I'm back at the start of the level. Alright. That machine huffing and puffing over there is the Duplicatron 1000. The D1000 will continue to create robots until it's destroyed. Be careful, though. It goes out with a bang. Okay, well. Well, there's a pair of underwear right there.
I feel like a new sponge.
Which was an interesting sentence I just said. Hey, another golden spatula! I have 5 now! I'd be able to go to the next area. Let's go to the jellyfish caves first.
Wow, Mermaid Man! I have all your comics and toys and mail!
You've met Mermaid Man several times before.
What? Oh, yeah, it's that sponge kid. And now, what was I supposed to tell you?
That Patrick is surrounded by robots and needs my help.
Huh? Oh, no. I think it had something to do with massaging my feet.
Is that the voice of Mermaid Man? I that doesn't sound like how I remember him.
Massaging your feet will save Patrick, then massage I must.
Help! They're making me hit myself!
Massaging your feet isn't working. I think I'd better try a more direct approach.
By clipping my toenails?
Here I come, Patrick!
You're right. There's a slide. When SpongeBob, Patrick, or Sandy jump onto a slide, they'll zip down the slope at hydrodynamic speeds. So apparently I can play as SpongeBob, Sandy, or Patrick in this game.
I love opening presents.
How are you talking that clearly when your tongue is being used as a board? Yeah. You need to get Patrick to Patrick to help him, but he's unreachable. Maybe these switches will create a way. The robots are guarding them heavily. You have to battle through. It's like a battle for the place I'm living, which is Bikini Bottom. It's like a battle for... Ah, I almost had it. I'm a dumbass. I forgot that they explode.
Just my size. Fresh like a spring breeze.
Is there a way to auto camera? Alright, I'm just like, options. Gameplay settings. Smart camera's on. Okay, whatever. Okay, that sucked.
You just met the Sponginator.
That was a lame joke. Even by my standards. Where's the other switch? Over there.
Too pretty. Cat, take it.
There we go. Push all the buttons. Do all the things. Get the golden spatulas! Collect all the shiny objects! I see why SpongeBob works so well in a collect-a-thon.
Hey, SpongeBob!
Woo! Thank goodness you're safe, Patrick.
Well, of course, SpongeBob. Why wouldn't I be?
Well, the robots and the...
Oh yeah, I found this for you. I don't know what it is, but it looks important.
Thanks, Patrick. I tell you what, all that running around has left me pooped. Why don't you continue on for a bit?
Okay. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
So, what just happened there was SpongeBob saved Patrick, and Patrick had a golden spatula. He gave it to SpongeBob, But really, he just left it out, and then I changed into Patrick, and then Patrick collected the golden spatula which he had. This is a throw fruit. Patrick can pick up throw fruit and press them. Press B to pick up nearby throw fruit, then press B again to throw it. Throw fruit can push buttons, destroy tikis, and damage robots. Use it quickly because throw fruit wilts after a few seconds. So in other words,
you gotta carry a lot of stuff around.
Seriously, is this... Are you just, like, purposefully giving me bad aim here? Oh. Oh, it hones in.
How many of these do I...
Patrick can also pick up and throw tikis, but only tikis that don't have other tikis stacked on top of them. Okay. Ow! Heck you. Patrick can throw fruit up steps, then climb these steps, pick up the fruit, and throw it again. But better hurry before it wilts. Alright. What was I supposed to do? Oh, I see. Nice. Okay. What's going on here? This is a bus stop. You may switch between playing SpongeBob or playing Patrick at bus stops. Got it. I'm gonna play as Patrick, though, for a while. Let me guess. I have to throw the fruit onto that target, and it'll fling me to the new area. Throw fruit stand. Yep. Alright. Thunder Tiki. When Patrick touches it, it will begin to storm after a few seconds and it will go boom. Don't be near it when it goes boom. Can I pick it up? Alright. Patrick can pick up Thunder Tiki and throw it just like other Tikis, but he better throw it fast. I just did that. Whoa. Oh. I didn't want to go here. What? Good aim, Patrick! Yeah, and I know you guys would be like, ah, that's totally not Patrick's fault. Why are all these random people here? I think I skipped a line of dialogue.
Here, you big pink lummox.
Oh, hi there, Mr. Plankton. Are you going to vaporize me today?
So very tempting. Unfortunately, I found myself in the undesirable position of having to assist you.
I was in an undesirable position yesterday, and now my neck hurts.
Heed my words, my large future minion. Go into Jellyfish Cave. Follow the instructions on the signs that you see. At the end of the caves, you'll still be a big pink idiot, but you'll know enough to help defeat the robots and get me back into the chum bucket.
Well, then will you vaporize me?
I might spare your life so I can force you to work in my sweatshop, making low-quality design and knockoff wallets.
Oh, thank you.
That was really weird. Patrick will slam down. Alright.
Ooh, scary dark cave. Ooh. Ouch.
Well, I'm getting my ass kicked by rocks. By rocks, it seems. Yep, rocks. I did not mean to destroy all of those, but I did. Alright, what's going on here? Remember, it can throw fruit, then pick up and throw it again before it wilts. So basically what you're saying is... hit it twice. Got it.
I don't think SpongeBob's underwear fits quite right.
I can't believe I didn't think of that. Alright, come on. Can you hit those things? You can! For some reason it wouldn't aim, but you could. Oh wait. I could just use this as well, I suppose. That one did aim. Weird. If I... oh no, I can't.
That's much better.
Right, I probably need to... that didn't feel good. I forgot that I can't jump. Why would you do that to me, game?
Ooh, up we go.
Why would you do that to me? Why? Whew. I don't think I need.
I don't think SpongeBob's underwear fits quite right.
Okay, that was funny the first time.
Ouch.
All right. Let's use this and hit. Oh, yeah. Oh, look, I almost... well, almost. I'm 800 shy of, I mean, less than 800. The weight, of throw fruit will also activate pressure plates. Neato. Patrick can also, jump on throw fruit to get to higher places. You may stack throw fruit as well by throwing a throw fruit on top of another throw fruit. This will allow Patrick to get to even higher places. The problem is the throw fruit kind of doesn't stay still. Oh, yeah, sure, this one stays still. Yeah. There we go. Wait, can I? Nope. But I can do this. Yeah, that works.
Teleportation.
Oh, shit. I was not expecting that. I couldn't tell that it was a slide.
I don't think SpongeBob's underwear fits quite right. Ooh, ouch. That's much better.
I really was not expecting that right at the start. This is freeze fruit. Patrick can pick up freeze fruit and throw it. Freeze fruit will temporarily freeze goo. Patrick can slide on goo until it thaws. Is there... oh! It freezes the entire thing. You look so happy doing that. If Patrick belly flops into robots, he can damage or stun them. Small robots will simply be defeated by Patrick's belly flop. Larger robots will be stunned for a short period of time.
Again.
Patrick may also use throw fruit to defeat robots. Thanks. And I felt like that was obvious, but okay. Patrick may even pick up robots he has stunned to throw them into other robots. That was my bad. Not my B. And there's another spatula, and look at that. I'm only 200 shy of the thing I said earlier. Yeah, I can pick them up and that kind of stuff. I can also just ram into them. I guess I just go to Jellyfish Lakes now?
Ahoy there! Squidward tells me you're looking for the King Jellyfish.
That sounds nothing like Mr. Krabs!
Yes.
Good thing, too. That monster has been stinging all my good customers in their poop decks. I hear that you can find him up top of Old Spork Mountain here. Go hook that beast, sailor!
Oh boy, Mr. Krabs. I'll see what I can do.
Alright. Oh, okay, yeah, that would just be the way back down the caves. Is that tartar sauce? Does it have tartar sauce? All right. So we have a ranged enemy is what I'm seeing here. Well.
Play as a whistle.
That way or this way. All right.
So shiny.
Why are you just standing here?
That's much better.
Hey, it's Mrs. Puff.
Hello, Mrs. Puff.
Oh.
Hello, Patrick. I've got a job for you to do.
Oh, boy.
I found a golden spatula, but those robots out on the island...
Man, I've been playing for over an hour already.
If you can figure out how to get it back, you're welcome to it.
Sam on the light. Oh. Yeah, I...
Sure enough, Mrs. Puff.
That was actually a really clever rhyme for someone who was supposed to be stupid. Whoops.
I don't think SpongeBob's underwear fits quite right.
Well, aren't you supposed to produce more things? There we go. Alright.
Play as a whistle.
So, yeah, I'm just gonna break all these houses and see what happens then, I suppose. This thing is glitched. So, I mean, good for me, I suppose. Oh, there's another one there. What? That wasn't close enough. Hey, there it is. I see it now.
SpongeBob's underwear fits quite right. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
Yeah! And I've been playing this for over an hour. It does not feel that long. be quite frank. Quite frankly. It's like I... Well, part of it is I still feel like it's the first area.
Well,
like,
done, Patrick. You're a real star.
Did I get a cookie?
No.
This very bit... No. There's something up there. I want it! This is a shtiki. SpongeBob will have to sneak up in order to destroy it. To sneak, move the stick gently or push the left trigger. Patrick may throw things from a distance. Alright. Let's switch to SpongeBob. Oh, I have over 3,000 now. I can get that thing from, Mr. Krabs. Mr. Krabs, I've got an idea! I'm gonna sneak up upon these shish-tikis, and then I'm gonna smash them the fucking bits! Yeah, that's fair. Okay, fair. These tikis won't know what hit them, Mr. Krabs! And then this game would be like, SpongeBob, my boy! I really appreciate that! It's because he sounds nothing like Mr. Krabs. Sponge boy, me Bob.
I feel like a new sponge.
Ugh, gug, gug, gug.
Hammer, I get it. Just my size.
All right. Left or right? Let's go left. SpongeBob should come back here when... Okay, so not left. Let's see how I'm doing for this area. Oh, look at that. Navigate the canyon and mesas. You do not... Have not received this task. I have 2 out of 14 socks. I'm actually not doing bad. I don't know how I'm missing so many socks, but I have most of the level completed. Yeah. I guess it must be like all the bonus things.
I love opening presents.
I hurt myself, but there's also health right there.
Like a spring breeze.
Mega combo. Oh, I see. I don't know, I like that little walk. Probably just because of the little tiddly noise. This is a stone tiki. It cannot be destroyed with ordinary moves, but it can be blown up by thunder tikis. Coincidentally, we put thunder tikis right next to both of them. And then I also stood close to one. All right.
Like a spring breeze.
Yeah, okay, I was gonna say, is that gonna blow it up, or do I have to go and hit it again? I don't think there's anything there. All right. Yes, of course I want to spend the shiny objects. I have... Wow. I have, 4,500, so definitely good for shiny objects. Man, there is... This game keeps going on.
Oh, I need to be Patrick for that one.
And that's another thing of why I'm glad I chose this game, or that this game got chosen, I should say. It totally lets me just do voice impressions for most of it. Is Super Monster Combo the highest level of combo? And is there an advantage to high combos? This is the question scientists don't want you to ask. Alright. Can I make it? Yes, I can. Okay. I see a sock!
Hey, you. Patrick needs to do laundry.
And I fucking... I can't believe SpongeBob's canonically dead. Do I still have that sock? Yeah. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I had two from the first Bikini Bottom area. From SpongeBob's house and all that kind of stuff. I'll go and double check. See if I can spot it. Ow. Fuck! I was underneath the ledge there. Ah, okay, it's gone, so. Okay. This one connected to somewhere? Here, that's weird. Okay. So. And fuck me. And SpongeBob just died. But I think... Oh no, there was a checkpoint right there. I would say, I think it's easier for me to teleport than to... keep going, but, I don't need to defeat you, I just need to walk away from you. Yes, walk away, SpongeBob! It's not worth dealing with. No, these assholes,
Patrick will be glad to have this back.
They're just always on your case, you know? Like, what can you fucking do? Oh man. Cartoon meant for kids swears like an adult is not like the most highbrow humor or even original humor. But every now and then, you know, it's good for a chuckle. There's an animation online of Tom Kenny actually doing the SpongeBob voice and swearing, so it's like, it's so weird. And then there's like a bunch of other characters, or other actors, I should say. Wait, I just saw that there's something down here.
Oh, sparkly.
Was there a point to this? Is there anything over here? Oh, there's a bus. SpongeBob can jump up walls when this symbol appears. Jump against a side wall and press A to jump again. Okay, was this the intended route? Or am I supposed to go this way? What I want to know is where the intended route is so I cannot go that way. Oh, I get it. They both get you up there. It's just options. You think? Yeah. Splat. Squashing bugs, it's where it's at. King jellyfish that way. Whoops. That spatula is just out in the open. Alright, that was an easy get. King jellyfish! This way! Let's go! La 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 la!
Bubble buddy! Gosh, everyone is trying to help out today!
Step quietly there. That king jellyfish is just up at the top of this path. Good luck! You'll need it.
Thanks, Bubble buddy. Fresh like a spring breeze.
How do you know what a breeze is?
I knew the king jellyfish was big, but who knew he had such a beautiful voice?
Slap him. Whoa. Oh, I get it. It's peanut butter on the thing because he's a jellyfish. Yeah, peanut butter and jelly. Slap him again! Don't tell me what to do, game. Actually, that's all video games do, is tell you what to do. Finishing slap! Oh, these are the thunder guys. You know, after I got the timing of it, it's...
You just met the Spongenator. Fresh like a spring breeze.
Alright. Come on, try that again. What? What? No, disagree! I totally... Got him! Okay. Weirdly pleasant goodbyes. Get the jelly. I found the jelly! You jelly? No! Alright. And then there's a box over here. Oh. Wait. Where's the other... Where do I go now? Oh, hey! That one, I could tell, was clearly a thing. I don't know how you're supposed to sneak up on these things while sliding, but okay.
It shines.
Oh, hey. Yeah! Spatula Seeker! I just got an achievement. Oh, hey, this is the start of the level again. Right? I'm not wrong here. This is, like, where I started off and... Exit? Yeah. Hey, it's Larry!
See, no problem. You could do anything you set your mind and your muscle to.
Okay. No, this is just a different area altogether. Okay. And I believe... Defeat King Jellyfish. No. I guess that I get if I talk to Squidward with the jelly. With the jelly? Jelly?
Oh, yeah. Oh, that feels so much better.
Anything for my best friend Squidward. Can I rub some on?
What if I just gave you this?
There we go. I got all of the, spatulas first try. Now I am missing 10 socks. I can see that one of them would be for Patrick over there. Let's see if I can switch characters somewhere. Okay, that was funny the first couple of times. Where is there a bus? That's what I need. I need a bus. Can I change characters, like, back in the main area and then come back as Patrick? I just remember that killing those guys gives me a bit more of the shiny objects. This reminds me a bit of the Lego games, where you just smash everything to make as much money as possible. Alright. Let's go back to Bikini Bottom. So, okay, so I have 5 for this area, and I think I have 10 for, like, another area. Yeah, look, there's another area over there, Goo Lagoon.
So, do you want to trade shiny objects for a golden spatula? That's quality craftsmanship.
Yes. I have a question. Does that count? Annoy Squidward. Top of the pineapple. No, that doesn't count. Okay, that's bizarre.
Your treasure chest's looking a bit light.
So, 350. And, oh, that's only 1,000 more. Honestly, I could probably go and get that.
Did you find my lost son?
Not yet, Pat.
Did they find you?
Wait, okay, so how... I want to swap characters right now. How do I can't swap characters out on this field? That's bizarre. I can't find a bus stop. I don't see a bus stop. All right, well. Yeah, jellyfish fields. Yeah. I know that Drain the Lake has a bus stop near it. So. Cause right there. Let's swap characters. And then... yeah. I'm just gonna go back to Squidward. Yeah, and now... do a bit of running. Imagine the music with Patrick's jump. That time I didn't really match it.
Sure gotta carry a lot of stuff around. Hey, this is mine!
I like that Patrick recognizes that.
So shiny.
Oh. Ah, cool. Just enough error time to get it. And there we are. So, I have way more than an... oh, I just automatically changed to SpongeBob if I exit a zone. Interesting. Well, let's go to downtown Bikini Bottom.
Metropolis, now a debris-covered crater.
Yeah, this kind of got fubbernucked.
SpongeBob, the robots are destroying downtown Bikini Bottom. We have to evacuate.
Mrs. Puff, how the fuck did you get here from the jellyfish field so fast?
All right, but it's gonna take a while to get all this dust.
Not vacuum, evacuate. We have
Boo! Boo! That was as bad as the Saboteur Sabretooth joke. Boo! Boo!
Can we just load them up in the boats?
That won't do any good.
Why not?
Because the robots have taken all the steering.
Couldn't we just drive in a straight line?
No, there are too many turns.
Those fiends, they thought of everything. Never fear, Mrs. Puff, I'll get those steering wheels back.
SpongeBob, if you're involved, I always fear.
Yeah.
But I tell you what, if you can pull this off, I'll give you a golden spatula.
How about a driver's license instead?
Nice try.
You know what? Upon thinking about it, Mrs. Puff might be like...
on the Bikini Bottom scavenger hunt. 3 years running.
Mrs. Puff might be my favorite character, upon reflection.
Up for a game of SpongeBob?
Ah! Ah! I did not know that's what would happen. Did I need those tikis to jump off of? There's a big statue here. I wonder what happened, like... okay. Oh. Whoop!
I love opening presents.
Cool.
Fresh like a spring breeze.
Nope. Fuck. After it fires, I should move. Because it's... after it fires, it has its target already. It's not like it's gonna move. Come on. There we go. Nice. I'm not even sure why I'm doing this. Except for the fact that it's available as something to do in the game. How do I get up there? Oh, actually pretty easily. Nope. Actually pretty easily, I say, as I fall off right away. Thirteen spatulas. I almost have enough to open, like, every zone in the starting area that I saw there. Alright. Oh, look, I already have enough to, Ah, crap. I already have enough to get the next golden spatula from Mr. Krabs. And since I'm reset to the start of the zone again... Actually, no, I want that sock. It was right there. I want that sock. Hi! I'm taking a screenshot of that one. All right. All right. Oh, there was a, there was a hint board right there next to the bowling sponge thing. Whoops.
So, do you want to trade shiny objects for a golden spatula? That's quality craftsmanship, that is. Come again.
14. All right. Yeah, okay, so if I don't kill these guys... No, I still can't make it up. Okay. When SpongeBob touches this ball, he will change into a sponge ball. You can roll quickly as SpongeBob, but you cannot do anything else. Being hurt or pressing any button will change you back. Okay. What? That was not something I was expecting to see all of a sudden. Meep. Hi, Gary. Gary, how'd you get up there? I do like that they don't just have, like, the invisible walls. They have dotted line walls. So. They at least let you know where it is you can go and where you can't go. What does this say? This robot is called G-Love. No, I don't like that name. I don't like that name. The best way to deal with them is to bubble bounce from above. Oh, okay. Was that an intentional rhyme? This robot here is called the G-Love. The best way to deal it is to bounce from above.
I love opening presents. Cha-ching!
No, I could have grabbed the underwear, but I don't think I have damage right now. I I'm gonna guess that that hot sauce will burn me if I touch it. And that's one of those best avoided things. All right. Yeah, here's the thing. They tell you,
pressing any button will make it,
stop. No, you can jump. You can do a little hop. Oh, hey, and now I've unlocked, this to go all the way around. Guys, this game's actually pretty fun, if not, like, a little basic. But, I mean, it's a game that was made, what, like, almost 20 years ago for kids. So I guess I can't fault it for being basic. Yes, I can. I can fault it for anything I want to. Whether I'm right about that is a different story. Another wheel! I wonder if I can... Let's crash the bank. Nope. Okay.
Bringing it around town.
Well, that's a fixed cannon, isn't it? Haha!
You weren't expecting that one, were you, shush tickies?
Actually... I probably should have, I probably should have, like, let them all be disappeared, and then I could have, just, it would have blown up the rocks, and then I could have just smashed them. The rock tiki's round town. Which door is this? Oh, that's not a door at all. Wee!
This door is locked from the inside. Who would do such a thing?
Someone who did it by accident. A game designer. A game designer. Yes, I answered the question correctly. A game designer would lock it.
Hey, you. Patrick needs to do laundry.
Man, there is a lot to this level. I'm not getting great rewards for going off the beaten path, but I am getting, like, a little level of enjoyment from it. And, like, yeah, collecting things. Like, I already have over 1,000 of these, what you call it? Oh my god. No, 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 no. Okay. I'm surprised this wall didn't blow up. Yeah, that was a big payday. Alright, so unlocking more walls at the very least. Why would you do that? Can I bounce on something here, or was it really just that? No, I can't. Okay. I like how there's not a run button. There is an anti-run button. Speed strats! Ah, my hubris! My hubris of... Yeah, I'm totally always gonna have enough. sure if I was supposed to be able to actually stand on that like that. Like that, like that, like that, like that. But I did, so. Oh, I was probably supposed to jump on the, lamp. Come on, lamp! Okay, well, whatever. Either way, I did it. And that's what counts. Because I'm a speedrunner. It doesn't matter how you accomplish it, just so long as it's done. And quickly.
Hi, Gary. Meow. Yes, thanks for noticing. I have been working out. Meow. Not done. Doesn't that mean meow?
Ooh.
Oh, that's the entrance to the rooftops which leads to the lighthouse? Aha! Uh-huh. There's another golden spatula. I could really use that. Meow. What do you mean get Sandy to help me? I can get through this. Oh, that gap looks big. Okay, I'm definitely not making that jump. How is anyone going to get across there? Uh-oh, more robots. Holy Dutchman's ghost! That gap looks impossible!
Just showing me the entire level there.
Okay, I'll go get Sandy to help me out.
Where's Sandy?
I love opening presents.
Oh, hey. And also, this. What's behind this house? Nothing! Yeah, that was actually a pretty big payday. Oh, hey! No, wait. Doesn't lead. How do I get back there? Do I actually have to just fall from above or something? Yeah, I think I do, because it looks like it's locked on all sides. Alright. Jump to the top of these steps. Sandy can glide across. Basically, by double jumping. Okay. Okay. Hey, Sandy! Wow, I didn't have to unlock her or anything. I mean, does she talk? Because so far, she's not talking.
Well, that's awful pretty.
There we go! No, okay. I'm assuming. Okay. You know, I might have made a bad assumption there. Okay.
Gotcha. Ew. Can't believe I'm wearing SpongeBob's underwear.
I can't believe it either. That feels like one of those shipping things. Okay, so those thing I can't lasso, I can only bop. More like Sponge Bop Squarepants. Yeah. Yeah, she was very silent for like An unusually long time. That was a weird way that I said it, but I said it. Alright. There we go. Sandy can do a chop attack by pressing X. If you chop while in the air, you'll perform a karate kick. Karate Kick has one word for some reason. Also, look how, like, the cursor randomly comes up. Alright. Sandy can lasso objects by pressing B. Okay. Nope. Yes! But now I think I need to redo everything there and get back and shit like that. I don't know why I'm wasting my time grabbing those. Was that worth it? Yeah, it was worth it. I needed to grab that anyways. Also, I don't know why I never did that. Well, there's nothing in here, so maybe that's a clear reason why I never did that. Also, I have almost enough money for that, what's it called? The clam. Clam jam. So, I wonder, like, if I don't play as Patrick at all in this stage and just as Sandy? And, like, can I go back and do the... I must be able to do the other level as Sandy and that kind of stuff. It has to unlock more abilities. Sandy can swing from a swing hook by pressing B. Oh, that's it. Then you can lasso a robot by pressing B. God damn it. Oh. I could just stand here and farm this one enemy. That's, yeah, that's like 50 shiny objects right there. 40. And it's not really taking me much effort. I could just stand here. Okay. I'm not going to. I feel like I would accomplish more by just continuing my journey. Okay, and then from here, I see it. And teleportation in case I fall the fuck off. That would be bad. Also, hey, I'm gonna, you know I'm gonna go for it. I mean, I kind of have to. And Sandy just destroyed a cannon with her bare fist. What the fuck? How strong is this squirrel? She is the original Squirrel Girl. Actually, not even. Squirrel Girl came long before her. But imagine, why there has to have been some fan art of Squirrel Girl and Sandy, like, pairing up. Some type of fan comic. Something like that. Alright. Let's travel to the rooftops! Shout it from the rooftop ship!
Hey, Harry, what's shaking?
Sandy! Boy, am I glad to see you. I need your help. My TV reception has been terrible lately. I need to have someone replace my old antenna with this shiny new one.
Yes, sir. That fair antenna is shinier than a $3 bill. Well, why don't you replace it yourself?
I'm not really much of a jumper.
So,
he's not a sweater?
What do you have to do with it?
Because the old antenna is up there.
Woo! That's taller than a glass of Texas iced tea.
The robots have blocked off that building, and I can't do all those fancy moves you and SpongeBob do to get across these gaps. All I could do is flex! Wanna see?
Yeah, great. So what are you gonna do with the old antenna?
Oh, that? It's yours if you replace it with a new one.
Well, I have been getting bad TV reception in the tree dome. Okay, Larry, you got a deal.
Is the old antenna just a, just a... I can't slam on this button? Oh. Haha.
Now I can!
I honestly wasn't expecting that when I did it. But I'm kind of happy I did. Alright, I'm gonna switch back to Sandy. Because it definitely feels like that's what I'm supposed to be right now. Sorry there. Yeah. I like how sometimes it's a, tutorial on the bottom there. You may use this teleportation box with others. Sometimes I have to read the thing. Reminder, Sandy, my God. Sometimes I have to read a sign. Well, that person's fucking dead. That person's fucking dead. I don't care if we saw that little cutscene. Can I, like... No, I can't catch their bullet or anything? If you say so. All right.
That's for messing with Texas. Someone better make good use of all these.
Look at how, yeah, I have, oh, okay, yeah, I have to get to that clam that I saw earlier with those. That's what I need to do with them. All right.
Kelpo.
All right. Oh, speaking of a clam, I need to pay. Shit. Okay, I thought that, like, it was high economy earlier because, like, the first couple of doors you find, it's, like, 10 or 50. But then... Here we have this crap of, like, yeah, you need 2,100. Oh, I see now. I see now.
Booyah!
Alright. And this is where I started off. Hey, Larry. Is this where... Does that just teleport to that one? No. Okay. So I just have to know when I've collected the... other one. Has anyone figured out where Bikini Bottom is in relation to our world? Because clearly Texas exists. So other, like, this exists on planet Earth. And there's, like, the American states and things like that. So have they figured out, like, where Bikini Bottom is? Nope. Not what I meant to do. Come on. Oh, yeah. I was golden there. Like that steering wheel. Here we go. All right. Haha. What? Why can't I target that one? Wait, what? Okay, there. All right. I need to find a checkpoint.
Okay, that's better.
There, perfect. Ask and ye shall receive. So, with that, I think it's time to... Fuck off. I think it's time to fuck off, yeah. I'm gonna kill that guy.
Can't believe I'm wearing SpongeBob's underwear.
And then we're gonna take our break. Midstream break. It is about time for that. So we're gonna go to the options. Save. We're gonna overwrite that. Alright. And, oh. And that is it for the first half of-